Hi, I'm Diane McGarry with Drake at Arts. Thank you for joining me today for our March 2024 Arts Saturday performance featuring the HarpBeat Duo. Harpist Shelley Otis performs as a soloist and with several ensembles. Highlights include opening for Maddy Prior at the Music Haven with Ulster Landing, the South Shore Folk Music Club in Kingston, Mass., the Boston Recorder Society Concert Series, and private events in France, Puerto Rico, and Mexico. As a composer and arranger for the harp, she draws on multiple music traditions and has traveled in Mexico, Chile, and Ecuador, interviewing harpists with the arpa llanera tradition. Fabio Pirozzolo is an Italian drummer, multi-percussionist, and singer. He began his career as a folk percussionist in a famous tarantella folk group traveling throughout Europe. He graduated from Berklee College of Music and co-founded the world ensemble Grand Fatale and the Italian folk music ensemble Nupoli. He currently is the drummer and percussionist for 8 groups, including Guru Ganesha Band, the Vanessa Triumph, and the Jumping Monkeys. Fabio authored the music transcriptions for Skip Hannon's Drum Books, Profiles in Jazz Drumming, and Broken Eight's Time Feel. And here you go. Here they are, the HarpBeat Duo. I hope you enjoy them as much as I do.
Thank you. a medley of songs. The first one was Eleanor Plunkett, which was by one of the most famous Irish harpists ever, Turlough O'Carolan, who lived in the late 16th, early 17th centuries. Late 17th, early 18th centuries. And the second one was called the Beltane Fire Dance. And there's many different versions of Beltane Fire Dances, but that particular melody, I believe, is from, written by Lorena McKennett. Someone asked me to learn that particular version for their wedding, and I only found that version by her. I don't know if it's by somebody else or not. And then the last one was one I wrote called Teresina. One of my favorite things about learning to play the harp has been exploring different harp traditions. And one of my most favorite harp traditions is the ones that come out of South America. And I actually was able to travel to Chile and Ecuador several years ago to learn more about the harp traditions there. So this next song was taught to me by a woman named Daniela Orlacon, and it's called La Petaquita, which means little box or little pocket, and the words are about maybe someday you'll open the box or the pocket and find it empty. And it's originally by Violeta Parra, who's a Chilean folk artist. And when I met with Daniela, I wanted to learn the cuenca, which is the traditional Chilean rhythm, but that was too complicated for me, not having grown up in that tradition. So this was the very first song that she learned on the harp, and this is what she taught me how to play. we're going to take you to Macedonia and the Balkan region. This song is called Jovano Jovanke, and it's popular all throughout the Balkan region in Bulgaria. And it's a song about two lovers whose parents did not approve, unfortunately, of their marriage or their love. So it's that song. Thank you. So now we're going to take you to Italy. This next set of songs is a tarantella, which is a traditional southern Italian dance. You want to tell them anything about it?
Of course.
Okay.
Good afternoon, good evening, good morning, whenever you're watching this. the next set of tunes we're going to play comes from southern Italy, that's where I'm from. And they come under the umbrella of tarantellas, which is nothing but a generic name for the dances and the music from southern Italy. The name tarantella is debatable. Some things come from the city of Taranto. Some things that it comes from the spider, the tarantula, that beats a person, possess the person, poison the person, and the person is to frantically dance to the music, which became the tarantella, in order for that person to heal him or herself, sweating the poison out of their body, collapsing on the floor. Sometimes there's religious figures attached to it, like Saint Paul of Galatina, or not. So sometimes there's different meaning attached to tarantella, just a dance for people to have fun, or a way for belief for women to express themselves in a society that was southern Italy up until the 50s and 60s that considered women to be less than men, at least in certain areas. So anyway, these two songs that we are going to play, one comes from the city of Vigiano, where the harp is actually a folk instrument. It's played in a folk tradition, sometimes unaccompanied. There's iconography, meaning like paintings that depicts harp players accompanied by clarinet and or wind instruments of sort and a tambourine. Sometimes the instrument is played solo. And then the other one instead that we medley into come from the Salento area, and it's a song that generically called pizzicarella. The pizzica is a tarantella from the area where this song comes from, and it was used as a ritual or an exorcism to heal people that were possessed by the spider poisons, and so they had to frantically dance, sweat the poison out, and maybe decide that they were cured or not. It's a very long story. If you're interested, Google it. It's a tarantella pizzica. It's very interesting. I can talk throughout the whole concert, but I'll stop right here for time's sake. Pizzicarella, and we're gonna start with
Tarantella di Armento.
Thank you. Thank you.
By the way, people often wonder what I'm doing up here. So I think I said in the interview, but in case you didn't see that, the harp is like a piano that's missing all of the black keys. So if you need other ones that aren't in that seven, you have to raise or lower a lever. So I'm just setting it up. And sometimes you have to do it during the song, which you'll see later on, but you almost always have to set it up ahead of time. So that's what I'm fiddling with up here. We're gonna go back to Bulgaria. This next song is it's called Snosti e dobro dosna sedela, and it's a song about a woman, a new bride who stayed up late at night spinning and weaving wedding gifts for her new in-laws. And I learned this a long time ago from an album of spinning and weaving songs. And I used to spin, so that's why I first became interested in it. But actually, I still do spin here. But I just love the song, and I love how it goes on the harp. So, and I have a friend from Bulgaria who helped me with the pronunciation. So if you are a native speaker of Bulgarian, I apologize for any mispronunciations. I'm trying. Thank you. song is a sort of a new twist on a very old tune. The old tune is Ode to Joy by Beethoven. And this is, there was one time, I don't remember exactly what I was doing. I think I was writing it out, or I was doing something, and I sort of made a mistake. And I was like, you know what, that might not sound bad. And then I kind of went with that and worked out this version of that song. So this is a tribute to, if you ever make a mistake, it might be better. Called Easily, and it's a song by Bruno Major, and I learned it for a wedding, actually a vow renewal ceremony, about a couple years ago, and I love how it sounded on the harp, and so we're going to play it for you now. Thank you. this next song is one that I wrote sort of as a way to practice my hand position while I was playing. So I was tuning one time and kind of heard a couple of notes together, and I was like, that might make something, that might make an interesting song. So I still haven't come up with a name for it yet. But here you are. It's sort of a tentative working title of It Comes Around Again, but I'm not sure on that yet. Initially got involved or interested in the South American harp tradition, and this is a song that I wrote just after I came back from Cozumel, when I first encountered the harpist there and came back with all these sounds in my head that I had to do something about. So I just, thinking about what I had heard there, and I kind of put them into the harp back in my living room at home, and this is what I came up with. So it's called Cozumel. Thank you. So we've been playing a lot of traditional music, music of various harp traditions, music of various other traditional traditions. But one of my favorite things to do with the harp is think outside the box. So now we're going to play some Beatles. This is Here Comes the Sun, which is appropriate for this time of year because the days are getting longer. It's almost the spring solstice, and the sun is coming back. One that I wrote that's sort of in the Celtic tradition, but with a new twist. I took a Celtic reel and an Irish reel and sort of added some strange chords. So I call it New Reel. Thank you. This last one is one that I learned for a wedding recently, and I love how it sounds on the harp, and I love it even more how it sounds with Fabio. So it's called Thousand Miles by Vanessa Carlton. Thank you so much for having us. It's been wonderful to play for you. Thank you.
Wow, that was incredible, Shelley and Fabio. Thank you so much. Also, I want to thank our very many sponsors for making these programs possible. If you're interested in being a sponsor, please go to drakeitarts.com/donate/. To learn more about this and other programs, please go to drakeitarts.com or email us at drakeitarts@gmail.com. This and all our programs are archived on the Drake It Arts YouTube channel. That's youtube.com/@drakeitarts. Thank you so much for being here.